Hello, I am Jack Parry-Jones and I play Michael in Moondogs. He's a 19-year-old who has failed his final exam, his final A-level, and he doesn't know what to do with his life. His girlfriend goes off, she's off to Glasgow to celebrate her life and to really enjoy herself, and he feels like he's being left behind. So Michael, feeling this, wants to make a change. What I should mention is that he's in Shetland, which is 14 hours away from Aberdeen, which is one of the most northerly points of Scotland. So to get to, well, mainland Scotland. So he goes on a road trip. He manages to get his brother, Thor, who is played by Christy O'Donnell, involved. And from there, they just embark on this journey. They meet up with Kathleen, Tara Lee, and he finds out that Thor has his own motives for going to Glasgow, and, you know, it kind of all ties together. But it's kind of more of a journey of discovery for the pair of them. They don't come back the same as when they left. They grow up a little bit, basically. Yeah, working with Christy was great. He's got such energy, and I think that is expressed through Thor, because he had to keep himself very still and kind of, you know, reserve himself to this cool character, and that's not Christy in any way. He's not that he's not cool. He's not cool. But he's just the way in which he conserve that energy, because it's like bouncing a ball in a room, in a very small room, and just waiting for it to stop. That's Christy when he starts talking, and he's just a wonderful person to be around. I can remember the first time that I met him, we were going to a gig with Anton Newcomb playing, who does the music for Moondogs. And it's a beautiful score, but we were going to this gig and Christy came over with a bag over one shoulder and a guitar case in the other, and he was just kind of like bundling over, massive smile on his face, and you just kind of go, oh, bloody hell, I'm working with this guy, he looks mental. And then we just instantly clicked, and, like, you know, we many drinks followed that, and then, he's been one of my best mates since. It was great working with Tara. Tara came meeting Christy, and then Tara came to the gig afterwards, and we kind of ambushed her, and then that just kind of set up the dynamic from then on, that she just stepped in and it was like, right, we're all mates. And Tara stepped up to it, and she was just, Tara is just really cool in real life. So there's no, oh no, I can't say that about her. I can't say that about her. It'll get too big. But she is, though. She is. She carries herself in a really cool way. She's an actress, musician, and, you know, has got an absolutely beautiful singing voice as well. I hope that she never sees this. I hope that she never sees this, because otherwise she'll just be like, oh, you've been talking so well about me. But we just had an absolute blast on it, and just the three of us together, the contrasting energies, and just the way that we interact in real life is very different to the way that we interact on camera. There's a lot of laughter between the three of us. Like, it seems that when we're together, that we're just constantly laughing or arguing or laughing, so it just continues in that loop. We've just had a blast. I can't really stress that enough. I think that road movies, because when I think road movie, I think about films like Easy Rider, for example, and that had something to say about that time, whereas you watch it now and it's such a fascinating study, I suppose, of that time. And I hope that this sets up as an interesting study of this time, because I do think that it does. I think that it shows the youth of today in a very interesting light, in a light that we want to Yeah, it feels like I was 26 when I made this film, but I remember what it was like to be that age, to be so hopeless and to actually not know what the hell is going on in your head, with your body, with absolutely everything, with exams, with so many things going on. And so it was quite easy for me to fall back into that. Whereas Christy and Tara, they were kind of going through it. They were only 20 years old when they made the film. I mean, they were going through it. And I just hope that people watch this film and see that, I hope that they see little parts of themselves within it. And I've chatted to people who have watched it, and they go, oh, actually, I really enjoyed this bit. And it's really surprising to find the parts that people really enjoy. And then they just end up unpacking stories from their childhood or stories from their life. And I think that's a really important thing. I think it's really important that, you know, it opens conversations, no matter how silly or daft they might be, as long as we're having conversations about our lives and we pass on stories for younger generations.